Today I'm starting my documentation process for the cover letter snippets application. This is the open source project that I chose to write documentation for and also record my writing process. And the first step of my writing process is user testing the application. So that's what I'm doing today. And I'm going to think out loud as I test the application, and I'm also going to note my observations in a Google document. So the first sentence of the application webpage is that it's an Angular MongoDB Node.js Express local application. So they start off with the tech stack, which makes sense if their audience is the recruiters, like creator of this project is applying for jobs and they want to present this project as an example of their technical skills, then it makes perfect sense to start with this with the tech stack. But if the audience is end users, then it might not make sense to start with the tech stack. So I'm going to make a note of it. Starting off with the tech stack. Yes, if the audience is recruiters. Might want to change it if the audience is non-developers. Okay, moving on. Local application for quickly composing a cover letter. For that discusses each keyword and technology on a job listing. I have a problem with the word quickly here because it kind of sets an expectation of how the user should be able to use it. Like if you're not able to do it quickly, then you're not good enough to use this application. What it adds an expectation for the user's technical expertise without adding any value to the sentence. So I'm just going to take it out. So I'm going to make a note of it. Okay, moving on, quickly composing a cover letter that discusses each keyword and technology on a job listing. This is not technically correct. We are not discussing each keyword and technology on a job listing. We are choosing the ones we want to discuss. So let's make a note of that. Remove each from the sentence. Okay, so let's scroll down to the actual README. Okay, let's just scroll down and see what we are working with. I love the screenshots. The screenshots are really, really good. It shows that they have put in a lot of efforts and that they really care about good documentation, and I'm very impressed with it. They also have good headings and subheadings, so it's easy and scannable. Let's make a note of that too. Okay, so first sentence is the same. The second one, you can use this tool to figure out what keywords appear most frequently in the job description and quickly add paragraphs from your previous cover letters that discuss those important keywords. So the two benefits of this tool are that you can analyze the keywords in a job description and you can reuse content from your existing cover letters. So let's make a note of that. Okay, let's scroll down to the actual installation instructions. Using snippets to install snippets. Run this command. There's an additional or optional command. And then to run the snippets, enter the command snippets to run the program. This will start a local host server that will serve the application on this local host, and a browser will open automatically. I think we can simplify these instructions, or like make them more scannable and just simplify them. So let's make a note of that. Okay, we also don't know if these instructions are applicable to all operating systems. Like, will this work on Windows? I don't know. I need to check. Okay. Now let's actually try running these instructions. Oh, the installation was so fast. Let's run it. Yay! It worked. Let me bring this to this browser. Okay, so use the JSON file. And connect to your database. So I can use the JSON file and connect to my database. What? Okay, let's see what the readme says. The easiest way to save your cover letter snippets is to store them in a JSON file. Okay. That's the JSON file. And you can click connect and create a file you can read from and write to. Okay. And you can also use an MLab database, which I think is a MongoDB database. There is also an existing database that you can use to try out the application. That's cool. That's a good move, like giving people something to play around with before having to set up their own database. Nice. I think we can simplify these options. Like, there are three options for the same task of connecting to your database. You can use it locally on using a JSON file, or you can connect to your MongoDB database, or you can use the existing MongoDB database. Okay. Okay, setting up a database. Snippets uses a MongoDB database on mlab.com to store your cover letter snippets data. Go to the website and sign up for login. Create new under new deployment. Click create new under deployments. Choose AWS. Pick a region. Follow the prompts. Click on your new data. All of this is to set up a new database. But as we just saw, that is just one of the options. And I don't think this is the most user-friendly option. Like, if I were given a choice, if I can do it locally, then I would just use a JSON file, or I would use the trial database that the creator has set up for me. So setting up a database on MongoDB feels like an advanced use case, and I don't know if that should be included here. These types are kind of breaking the flow, so I think I'm just going to have a quick start setup without MongoDB and then an advanced setup with MongoDB. Hmm. Okay, moving on to adding snippets. Copy paste a small snippet of a previous cover letter. Okay, so that's a requirement that I need to have a previous cover letter handy to add snippets from the previous cover letter, and we need to call out that requirement. Fill out the categories field with the keywords, blah blah blah. It's also important for you to add an intro and outro category. Let's try this out. Connect to JSON file. Okay, this is an example snippet from the new JSON file. Delete me, create new ones. This is a trial snippet, okay. Okay, it says to delete the first snippet, so I'm going to do that. Now let's add a snippet. Enter a snippet from your cover letter that you feel is well articulated and communicates your experience well. Then fill out the categories that relate to this cover letter. Okay. For now, I'm just going to type in a paragraph about my experience as a tech writer, and not bother with opening my actual cover letter because I don't know where it is. I need to hunt it down. And that's not important right now. I just need to try out this application. And I'm also trying to put in keywords that I know will show up in the job listings so that we can see if the application picks those keywords and matches it to the job listing when we add the job listing. Okay, so I think I have enough keywords here. DigitalOcean, AWS, GCP, Markdown, GitHub, and Jekyll, yeah. Okay, so we added a snippet. Now we need intro and outro snippets. I'm just gonna put dummy text. Okay, editing snippets. My database page, we should see a list of all snippets. Yes, our added snippets are here. Yay! Now we can proceed to building a cover letter. Awesome. So we need a job description. I'm going to look up the technical writing job on the Cockroach Labs website, and I'm just going to copy paste our description that I know matches the keywords that I've entered into the cover letter snippets app. Okay, so I've added the job description. And I know that I used the keyword markdown, so it should show up somewhere on this page. Where do I see the snippets? Show intros. There are no intro snippets. Show more. Oh, there they are. Okay, here are all the snippets that I've added. Yay, I can see the markdown snippet. Nice. And then I also have an outro snippet. Awesome. But I don't have an intro snippet. I do have an intro snippet. Why wouldn't this show up? Oh, because the I is capital? Do you need that to be small letters? Does that work? I'm gonna check. Oh wow, it showed up. Huh. So the categories are case sensitive. That is a very important find that we need to make a note of. Another important point is that to edit the text, you need to click inside the box. That is not very intuitive. Actually build a cover letter. So let's select the markdown snippet, add, and then let's also have an intro snippet. Where did my intro snippet go? What? And also let's add an outro snippet. Why wouldn't my intro snippet show up? What? I did add it. I can see it here. Why can't I see it on the build a cover letter page? This is so strange. Show intros. What? Why isn't the intro snippet showing up? I'm just going to try adding a new one now. This is an intro. Let's see if it shows up now. It does! That is so strange. I don't know why it didn't show up in the first place. But I'm glad it did now. I'm just going to rearrange this thing. And yay! We have built our cover letter. That is so awesome. How do I export the cover letter though? Let's see what the readme says about this. Okay, we did all of that. Export cover letter. You're basically done. You can edit the text in the text area and can copy paste your cover letter into your Word doc or PDF. So it does not really generate a Word document or a PDF. You have to do that manually, and that needs to be called out. Okay, so this is the end of the readme, which means this is the end of the user test. We went through all the four steps of creating a cover letter, and we also took detailed notes about what we want to include in our new readme. I think this was a very successful user testing session, and I'm pretty happy with it. In the next session, we will write the actual readme. I'll see you then. Bye!